Hey everyone, welcome back to Modern Retro Gal. My name's JL. Today's video, I'm really excited because we are bringing back an oldie but a goodie, but the oh-so-fun unboxing of BoxyCharm subscription boxes. I used to subscribe to BoxyCharm and just decided that I had too much product. I wasn't going through it, so I had canceled my subscription, and I decided, you know what, I really miss it, so I'm gonna go back. So if you are curious to see what my thoughts are on the August box and some of the changes that BoxyCharm has made with their subscription boxes, you're gonna wanna keep watching. If you are new to my channel, hello, how's it going? So glad to have you here. I hope that you will stay. Be sure to click that subscribe button down below and click the bell so you're always notified when I upload. I am over 40. I like makeup, I like skincare, I love vintage things and styling. So if that sounds interesting to you, I hope you will stick around. So if you're curious to see what is in the August box and my thoughts, just keep watching. Okay, so the way it works now is they have a base box, which is what I chose. It is $25 a month. BoxyCharm chooses all of the products for you. The boxes are all different. Some of them repeat. It just sort of depends on the product that they have. They now have a luxe box that you can upgrade to. I believe you have to get at least one base box before you can upgrade to the luxe box. Or I'm sorry, the premium box. The premium box is $35 a month. You get, I think it said 7 full-size products. With the base, you get 5 full-size products. So with the premium, you get to choose 2 of your products every month. And then they have a luxe box that you can also upgrade to. That is an additional $24.99 every 3 months on top of either your base or premium box, I believe. I'm not sure if you have to have the premium box in order to upgrade to the luxe box. It's a little confusing, but I will have links for their website down below, and you can kind of look at it. That is a box that is higher in value. I think there's like 9 products in it or something like that. And again, it's an additional $24.99 every 3 months. So that is the way the boxes work now. You do a kind of like user profile when you sign up. So you talk about, you answer questions about yourself. If you want products that you are going to be comfortable with, I would recommend answering the questions completely truthful. If you want some more adventurous products or to try, really kind of try new things and expand your horizons, I would kind of fudge and answer the questions like with a little bit more, I guess, advanced answers or more adventurous answers, kind of a thing. You can also choose if you prefer mostly makeup or mostly skincare, or if you would like something in the middle. I chose something in the middle. Previously, I requested mostly makeup, and almost all of the boxes that I got, I would say like every month, 4 out of the 5 products were makeup. I occasionally got skincare. I decided to mix it up this time just to kind of see what would happen with the box. This month I got 3 skincare and 2 makeup items, but you can choose accordingly. They do say, however, depending on the product that they have in hand for each box, they can't guarantee that you will have mostly makeup or mostly skincare. It kind of depends on what they have for that month. So there is a variety in the boxes. I think they have like a set amount of product mixture for the boxes for people that kind of generally fall into certain categories. They do try to give you products that will work with your skin tone and your skin concerns, but again, they have a lot of subscribers, and so it's a little bit difficult to have 100% customized boxes for each person. I think that's kind of where the premium and luxe boxes come into. I think you have a little bit of say in the premium box also. I could be wrong, so don't quote me, but I think with the premium or with the luxe box, you have a little bit of say in what you want. So let's get into what I got in my box, how I feel about it. One other side note, is that BoxyCharm is not necessarily a cruelty-free subscription box. However, I would say about 90% of what they put in the boxes is cruelty-free. You may just want to check the products to be sure before you try them out. I would just say anything that you get that isn't cruelty-free and or vegan, maybe just donate to like a women's shelter or a program that helps, women starting over. That's a great way to send those products along. So this is our August box. You always get a little card. It has the products in here. I am going to start with the makeup products because we do have a mascara in this box. I have been using some of these products. I like to do a try on with my videos. So if there's any skincare, I like to use it at least once or twice to kind of give you an idea of how I feel about that product. Also, because this is my first box and I re-signed up basically as a new customer, I received a bonus item. It was an item that I was able to choose. I chose a skincare product and I will let you know how I feel about that when we get to it. But let's start with the makeup. So the first product I'm actually going to show you is one that I'm not going to be using because unfortunately, even though this brand is cruelty-free, there's a little bit of like, I feel like a gray area. So I don't know if it's Lavea, I'm not sure how to pronounce it. But they make lashes. They do mink and faux mink. They claim that their mink lashes are cruelty-free. I don't see how mink lashes can be cruelty-free. I know this is kind of like a weird gray area. I don't always use vegan products. But the way they get the hair from the minks is to have them in cages in captivity, basically. So it just kind of feels a little bit weird for me. But this set this is their Flirty Lash set. It includes their best-selling 3D Mink Flirty Lash, a clear and latex-free brush on adhesive, eyelash adhesive, and a gold applicator. And this retails for $54. It says new launch, so I think this is something that is new for the boxes. Next up is a mascara. This is a company called Rockins Cosmetic. This is their All Night Bender mascara. It looks like this. This is a UK brand. I had never heard of it before, but the description of the mascara says bend and extend with Rockins All Night Bender Extreme Lash Mascara. Rockins bent wand and fine tip has a design to reach and grab each tiny individual inside lash, shape and sculpt, separate, extend the outside lashes. Smooth gliding formula. This is vegan and cruelty free. It retails for $29. I really, really love the brush, especially if you have hooded eyes. This is a great brush for hooded eyes. I really love the formula. I love the way my lashes look. They are extremely separated and lengthened and definitely there. It's a great mascara. The company kind of is based around like 70s rock era, which I super love. So I'm going to go ahead and put this on and I will be right back. All right, so I am back. I'm not sure how big of a difference you can notice just on film. I'll try to zoom in a little bit and hopefully you can kind of see the difference that this made. But I love it. It really helps curl my lashes, which are very straight. And when I do curl them separately, it really, really holds the curl well. I've just been loving the heck out of this mascara and it's definitely one that I will repurchase in the future. So this is a big win for me. One product that is sort of in between makeup, in between skincare is from the brand, where is it on here? Truly Beauty. This is the Purple Haze CBD Glossy Lip Butter. You can find this at Ulta. All of their products always like have this kind of whipped look to it. And I really like this. Some of the reviews were very mixed online as to whether people liked it. It is very glossy. At a certain point, it does sort of soak in, and then your lips just kind of, mine end up feeling just kind of velvety smooth. So you just get a little bit, I'll show you on the back of your hand, and as you warm it up, it turns into just a glossy lip balm. I find it to be very hydrating, really nice. It smells good. It smells like pineapple 100%. So I've just been really enjoying it. It's $16. It says benefits of hemp, jojoba, and vitamin E to hydrate and condition your lips. And I know that this brand is cruelty-free. I love using it as an overnight lip balm. I believe also vegan, but I think you just kind of have to check their individual products to see if they're vegan. So I have just been loving that product. I think it's really amazing. Next up on our list is from Kate Somerville. This is the Exfoliate Glow Moisturizer. Get rid of the box. So it looks like this, and look how cute the top is. I just thought that was adorable. The one thing kind of downside for this is that it is a dip jar. I do have a little skincare spatula that I use to get in there, but I do wish that they would do like a pump top or just a squeeze top. I think it's just better and it makes the product last longer. So it says revive dull, dry, lackluster skin. Powerhouse ingredients remove dead skin while smoothing fine lines and wrinkles. It has lactic acid and hyaluronic acid in it. So I have been using this during the day and it's really lovely. I do like it. Because it does have AHA in it, you want to make sure that you are using sunscreen during the day. This can be used day or night. I have something else that I've been using at night that I will show you last. However, I will say because this does have lactic acid in it, you just want to be careful when pairing it with any other acid products. Just to make sure that you're not over exfoliating or that you don't have a weird reaction. You would not want to mix this with a retinol product at night, and you just want to be careful if you have any acids like lactic acid, what are the other ones? Salicylic acid, just any of those other like exfoliating acids. You just want to be careful mixing so that you don't get over exfoliated. I do love this, however, at $70. Oh, thank goodness I only paid $25 for the box. I am not sure if I will repurchase it again in the future or how soon, but I have been really, really enjoying this. Next, we have this product. This is from Clean Skin Club. This is the Clean Slate Clearing Mist. This has salicylic acid, rose acid, extract and eucalyptus oil. Again, this is another product with an acid, so you would want to be careful if you had this box mixing these two together if you are not used to it. But it's basically a toner. The mister is amazing. Like, this is the finest, I don't even know if you can see that, mist ever. It smells amazing. It smells like expensive spa amazing. If you are allergic to any kind of rose product, you are not going to want to use this because I saw someone else put this on their face thinking that they would be okay with rose extract when they were allergic to rose water, had a severe face reaction. The only thing that I personally find a little strange about this is that this is basically for acne because it's got salicylic acid in it, but you're spraying it all over your face. So you're getting it on like your lips and your eyes. And it says avoid contact with eyes. I'm sure it means like getting it in your eye, but I do find that a little weird that you are spraying this on your face and getting it places where you may not want this to go. So to use it, I would probably personally spray either some into my hand and press it into my face, or put it on a cotton pad and spray it onto that and then wipe it. Let me know your thoughts on that. Does it seem strange that this is in a spray bottle when you're supposed to avoid it getting it on sensitive skin areas, like around your eyes? It's very sensitive. It just seems a little strange to me. But it smells amazing, and I haven't used it a ton because I have another product that I've been using. But I'll definitely put this in the rotation. It is safe to use things like salicylic acid and lactic acid together. You just want to go slow with that if you are not someone who is used to mixing acids together in your skincare. I do have a whole video on different kind of exfoliators, which salicylic acid is technically an exfoliating acid. I will link it. I think it ends up here. I can't remember. But I do have a video on exfoliating where I talk about the different types of acids and what they do, and the pros and cons of mixing those acids. But this guy right here retails for $38. So not a totally bad price, depending on how long it takes for you to get through it. So that is the total of the box that went out to everyone. So the total of the box comes to $207, which is a really amazing price when I only paid $25 for it. If you subtracted out the lashes, it would be $153 value of product, approximately. I think I did the math right there, that I will be using. The bonus item that I got is actually from Murad. This is Environmental Shield. This is the City Skin Overnight Detox Moisturizer. This is in their vitamin C range that looks like this. And it has this great like pump top. There we go. You just wipe it off and then rub it in. This is the kind of top that I wish the Kate Exfoliate Glow had, but this is an overnight cream. I love this stuff. I love it. It is so good. My face feels so good in the morning. Let me tell you, it's super awesome. So this is a great bonus. This is a $74 value. So with this, the total of the box was $281 and I paid $25 for it. So not too shabby. But overall, I do really love everything in the box. I will have to use this a little bit more the way I would personally want to use it. Not sprayed all over my face, but concentrated on like a cotton pad and then rubbed in. I knew I would be rolling the dice in getting a product that is not cruelty-free. Before I go, I do need your help. If you have not subscribed to my channel yet, I really would love for you to help me out. I am trying to reach 2,000 subscribers by the end of the year. So if you could go ahead and click the subscribe button, I will also have a little subscribe situation going on up here somewhere that you can also click on. And yeah, don't forget to click the notification bell, and then you'll always be notified when I upload. So that is it for BoxyCharm for this month. Are you excited for next month? Was there anything in the August box that you would want to try? Let me know down below. I'd love to chat with you about the products and all things BoxyCharm. So I am going to be getting ready to start a new makeup series. It is going to be fall makeup. There will be three looks. There will be kind of a more like classic retro look. There will be a like fun color fall look. And then there will be like a glam fall look. And I'm going to start doing that for each season. So next video will be a makeup, the first in the fall makeup looks. I know it's not officially fall yet, but you know, let's just go ahead and get started. So that's it for me. I hope you enjoyed yourself. Please give this a like, and I hope you all are doing well, and I will see you again soon.